So most of you have answered it correct. Okay, so 44, rest of you have still confusion. I don't know why you marked thyroxine and all. So ADH hormone, we just now talked about this ADH hormone, antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuresis means going for urination again and again. So preventing the urination when you are under stress, when you are under dehydration, you don't go, you don't remember to go to the toilet and relieve yourself. Okay, so it's the hormone which will help you forget about urination, will make your urine concentrate by pressing your blood vessels and going the water and preventing the flow of water into your kidney. Okay, so this hormone is released from the pituitary. What hint I gave from the previous question was the aldosterone hormone is mainly secreted by the adrenal gland, which is like a happy birthday cap above the kidneys. This hormone is secreted by the pituitary, which is a small gland which releases your growth hormone also. Okay, so the aldosterone helps in the salt water balance, salt water mineral balance, sodium potassium balance, whereas vasopressin works in a dehydration condition, extreme dehydration condition. Okay, no, it's not opposite. So everybody's bodies works in a different way when you are in stress. Okay, yeah, I hope it's clear. We can go to the next question. Guys, just don't simply type why. Put up a sentence after why. Okay, I can see a new name, Sanjana. Anish, Naomi is the fastest. Anisha, not Anish. Okay, girls are leading the quiz, this biology quiz. Now, this is a good question, guys. It's quite a good question to be thought about. It's a very, very good question and a good insight. Nobody would have told you about this question. Never ever you will encounter such kind of question. Think about it. You have 30 seconds. Patiently think about it. Do not Google. Do not take help of Siri. Be independent. Atmanirbhar bano. Okay, so is it easy? Let's see what is the, but yeah, even if it is easy, it's a good question. Yeah, so yeah, most of you have got it correct. Really good. It's quite a good question. Okay, so basically the oxygen which is not used by us is basically acting as a reserve during muscle exercises. Okay, it is not helping in the exchange of O2, and it is not doing anything else. We just keep that oxygen for during our muscle exercise, when our muscles are getting utilized, in order to prevent the quick start of the anaerobic process. We keep it as a reservoir. That's okay, Surya. It's a good insight. That's what I was telling you. No, hardly people tell about this. So it's a good question. I like this question a lot. Okay, guys. Anything else? Shall we proceed to the next question? Yeah, leaderboard. I can see new names. Aryan Singhal. Good job, Aryan. But you can. Tavishi. Nice. I can see new names every time, not the same ones. Good job, guys. Yes. We can go to the next question. Now, this is kind of an easy question, but it's like a correlated question. Two, three chapters are correlated, and I don't know whether you know about the things mentioned in the options. Let's see what is the outcome of this question. That's okay. If you don't know, we'll be telling you. If you know, then it's like a check on yourself. So 29 of you have got it right. Okay, so yeah, we discussed this question. We haven't learned 99.9% of the quiz, but people are answering. People are giving a good, people are answering it really nicely. Okay, guys, I will tell you this question. So you know, you talk about the adrenaline rush when you play some game or something, when you go on a roller coaster ride. You feel really good. Your heart starts pumping the blood, and you get that adrenaline rush kind of thing. So guys, how it is happening? Okay, I will tell you how to generally give an answer for this question. Oxyntic cells are in stomach. Nothing as such happens in stomach. Okay, islets of Langerhans are mainly related with the pancreas. Okay, just hold on. Okay, and dorsal root ganglia of the spinal cord. So spinal cord can be confusing because it is mainly related to reflex action, but nothing like reflex is happening here. It's just the hormone is acting on your heart. Okay, it's acting on your heart and the battery of the heart, which is placed in the atria, which is your pacemaker. Okay, it is affecting your heart to increase the heartbeat. The heartbeat is increased, and hence, you get that feeling of excitement. Okay, so the adrenaline acts on your heart. Okay, and the heart pumps faster, so that's how it is connected. And the answer is sinoatrial node. I hope you guys know sinoatrial node. If you want me to explain, I can explain. Yeah. Islets of Langerhans are the regions of pancreas which contains the cells which secretes insulin and glucagon. Yeah, good. Islets of Langerhans are the structure which is going to secrete the hormone insulin and glucagon. So mainly these are the structures which are associated with the endocrine part of pancreas. Exocrine part of pancreas is about the enzymes, pancreatic enzymes. Yeah. Any other doubt? Insulin and glucagon. Yeah. So insulin puts the blood sugar in the cell. Glucagon takes it out from the reservoir. So whatever you are eating is going into your blood and from the blood to cell. The insulin is helping the sugar to go from blood to your cell, and glucagon gets the sugar out of the reservoir, like liver and all. No, it's not stores glucose, it just carry out the metabolism of the glucose, not storage. We don't want to store it, we used to use it to burn energy. It's a calorie for us. Getting my point? Yeah. Guys, okay. Can we move to the next question? Leaderboard, leaderboard. let's see. Good job, Aryan, Kiran Mai. Okay, I cannot see any other here. So Aryan is maintaining the position. Hope Aryan, you're not using Google. Hope Aryan is an honest child. Yeah, Alicia, I will repeat after the next question. I will address your question. Don't worry. Is it okay? Now, guys, easy question. Look at this question. Super easy question, 100% right. Super duper easy question. I hope you should get 100% right. That's okay. We'll see the shuffling on leaderboard then. Okay. The way of your answer will affect the leaderboard, so that's okay. 3 seconds, 4 seconds. Yeah. This question, my God, it was a super easy question, right? 66 of you have got it right. Means like the basics are okay. People are okay with the basics. That's okay. That's really good. So pulmonary artery is the artery, like which is carrying the deoxygenated blood. But sometimes my student will ask me, Ma'am, why they are naming it as an artery? Can't they name it like vein? Why they have to complicate everything? Bio. So the concept here is artery always carry the blood from the heart towards the organ, which is being satisfied by the pulmonary artery. So it always carry the blood from the heart towards the organ, which is satisfied by the pulmonary artery. Though it carries the deoxygenated blood, but is carrying the blood away from the heart, right? Okay, and one more thing is the previous girl was asking Ananya, what is glucagon? So glucagon is a counter hormone of insulin. It brings out the sugar from the reservoir. Okay, it will break fat, convert into sugar, break protein, convert into sugar. Okay, it will bring out the sugar from the cells or the reservoir when we need energy. Okay? Yeah? Okay, Ananya. Yeah, guys, let's go to the next question. Leaderboard. Let's see the shuffle. Aryan, Kiran Maitavishi. Same, yeah, no shuffle. Everybody be ready to attack on Aryan. He's getting too smart. Momita, whenever we need energy, whenever we need energy, we have to get it from the reservoirs. Okay, we have to get it from the reservoir. If we don't have, focus on the next question, then we will answer this question. Guys, I don't know how is going to be this question. Everybody has to attack Aryan. Yeah, Aryan is being so smart. Don't dissect it, guys. People have dissected it and people have given you the information. You need to kill so many frogs to get an answers. What if he has cancer? Anish, Yeah, it's banned. Killing of frog, sacrificing of frog in the name of science is banned now. Yes. Guys, focus on answering the question. Few seconds left. Oh my God, so many of you Googled it. Nice. All you guys knew it. What about cockroaches? Cockroaches have a different kind of heart. Cockroaches have 13 chambered heart. Okay, we can see the question. Can we go to the question? So the answer is three because heart of amphibian is a three chambered heart, and there's a like there is a this thing there is a valve which is there for carrying the which is stopping the blood vessels, the blood to go into the blood vessel when the blood is getting transported to the other parts of the frog body. Okay, so there are three chambers in a amphibian heart. When we talk about the reptiles also have three chambered heart except crocodile, alligator, and gavialis. Okay, so the reptiles also have three chambered heart. So this is like the evolution. Nature is coming with the best design for humans. So it is experimenting on amphibians, it is experimenting on reptiles, and the best form of heart is the human heart. Okay, घड़ियाल, गैवियालिस, गैवियालिस, घड़ियाल तो एलिगेटर होता है बेटा, गैवियालिस इज अनदर काइंड ऑफ क्रोकोडाइल लाइक रेप्टाइल. या वी कैन गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. गैवियालिस नॉट घड़ियाल. Oh my God, Aryan is giving good answers, yeah. What everybody is doing, yeah? Sai Anirudh is active now. Welcome, Anirudh. So Aryan is now a biology student, converted student from biology to maths. We can go to the next question, sir.
अच्छा
नहीं
है। चिता हाँ
It's again an easy question, guys.
ये
Somebody is
नहीं ओके
unmuted. Can you guys please mute yourself? Code is 933445. I will tell you a trick, Aditya, after the question. There won't be any confusion later on. The options are quite clear. Anirudh, just don't overthink. Instead of overthinking, try to focus. That's okay. That's okay. We'll talk about it. Try to give the best possible answer. Yeah. So, like, yeah, the 44 students have tried to give the best possible answer. So, those who have the problem in remembering is like remember L O R D. Okay, L O R D. Okay, left oxygenated, right deoxygenated. Okay, left chamber deals with the deoxygenated blood from vena cava. What is wrong? Just it has moved from like this thing. okay, no need to panic, just use your logic, deoxygenated, comma, vinakava. So it's like LORD, left oxygenated, right deoxygenated. Okay, so very easy question, be deoxygenated blood from vinakava. There's nothing wrong with the oxygen option, sorry, just the questions, the thing has been moved a little. No, yeah, it's not incomplete, guys. Sometimes it happens, printing and arranging, formatting thing. It's just a simple formatting thing and it's quite clear, right? Deoxygenated, vena cava, it's not even incomplete. Alignment, yeah, alignment issue happened, but it can be used, it can be thought over, right? So I think we can go to the leaderboard. I hope there's no doubt. That's okay, Ananya, that's okay. So Aryan is my converted student. He has given up maths and he has come to biology. Aryan is going to be my future doctor. Isn't it, Aryan? Yeah, we can go to the next question. Super easy question, 100% right, 100% right. We don't have much time for this question, okay. Super easy question. I think I should get the answer 100% right. Wow. Okay, what about rest of you guys? It's a 7th standard question. Phloem food. Fur. Okay, if you have problem and confusion in remembering whether it's xylem or it's phloem, you can use it as fur, phloem, food. So it's the phloem which transports the food, right? We can go to the leaderboard, sir. I don't think there has to be any discussion. Yeah, not much shuffle. We can go to the next question. I think everybody is clear with the answer. Again, an easy question. Few beginning questions were difficult. Now rest are easy. And you have a lot of time. Aditya, please be a little bit aware, be a little bit open with your brain and senses, other senses. Yeah, 100% correct. Approximately. So it's the capillaries, guys. Capillaries are the single line. No, it was not at all a trick question. It was a super easy question, Laksh. So capillaries are basically the single layer of epithelial cells. And the process of diffusion is very, very easy for easy there. Okay, we can go to the next question. Aryan is going to kill it today. What you guys are doing, yeah? Shardali, Mamita, Shreyas, Anirudh Sai has reached the third position. Okay, guys, let's see. Let's attack Aryan. He's being too smart. Not everything gets exchanged with the capillaries. Right? Even if it is WBC also, they also get exchanged easily. Okay, next question. Again, it's a super easy question. Yeah, it should be 51 correct. Oh my God, so many people are correct. So many people are correct. So natural, so approximately 20, sorry, there are 16 macro elements and micro elements, out of which 14 are obtained from the obtained or 14th are obtained from soil and rest of them are obtained from air and water. Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are obtained from air and water. Okay, we can go to the leaderboard. Shardali, open your senses. Aryan, what you guys are doing, yeah? Why is he on first position? Pull him down. No, it's not a trick question. Momita, don't give them hints, huh? Yeah. Okay, it's like the sphygmomanometer. It's like the instrument which is going to measure your blood pressure. Whatever the heart is going to give out the systolic pressure and diastolic pressure. That is by ha your heart, okay, and that is given by heart and which is going to act on the walls of your arteries, okay. So that is your heart pressure, similar to your blood pressure, and it is measured by sphygmomanometer. So it's the blood pressure instrument that you see, and you use the mercury as a liquid to measure the pressure. Whereas ECG is known as electrocardiogram or graph. Here it is a little ulta, opposite. Gram is the paper and graph is the instrument. EEG is electroencephalogram, and B is your stethoscope, is your the device which is used to hear the heart sound, proper functioning of your heart sound, right? We can go to the leaderboard. Okay, one second, let me see the charts, what is going on. It is useful for EEG, is used for that thing, your electroencephalogram, yeah. Oh, Aryan is still on the first position. Guys, what you are doing, huh? Pull him down. Tavishi is on the first position. Yeah, Aryan. Try to come on the first position again. Okay, next question. Everybody try to, answer it nicely. Again, an easy question according to me. Okay, let's see. It was an easy question. Oh my god, so many of you have studied it really nicely. That's good to see. So yeah, there are steps in the urine formation. One is the filtration step, where everything will get filtered, everything except blood will get filtered, okay, and then whatever extra has been filtered is reabsorbed, like glucose, like proteins, like amino acids, like salts is reabsorbed, and everything gets filtered structure which is known as glomerulus and Bowman's capsule, if you have done this in your 7th standard. And then there is a loop like structure in the nephron where the reabsorption occurs slowly. Okay, so and this was there in 7th grade, yeah, this was there. You might not have studied, but my 7th graders know this already. Okay guys, let's see the leaderboard. We have 5 questions and we don't have much time. Okay, that's okay. Let's, I think you can like think about this, little bit think about this. Yeah, so we got a kind of shuffle. Okay, I will explain you this question, and when you will do the expression chapter, Anshul ma'am will explain you in detail. So guys, when we talk about the loop of Henle, it's like a hairpin, right? It's like a U-shaped structure. So half of the part deals with the passive transport, half of the part deals with the active transport. Okay, passive means like by simple diffusion based on the concentration difference. Okay, I will use the board to explain the questions. Can you stop your screen for a while? How many questions are left? Okay, we have 15 minutes. So I'll use this question I'll use the screen to explain this question. So can you stop sharing? I'll share my screen. One second. How to share the screen? Can you see the screen? Sir, how to share the whiteboard? I forgot.
Sunil, when you click, like instead of
Share my screen. Yeah, I
when
got
you click
that.
share screen,
Sorry.
you will get
Yeah.
options here.
Okay. So guys, this is your loop of Henle, right? Okay. Around this loop of Henle, there will be a blood vessel. Okay, there is a blood vessel which is known as vasa recta. Okay. Now, this is flowing in this direction. If this is flowing in this direction, the blood in this blood vessel will be flowing in opposite direction. So the exchange is easy. This part of the loop of Henle deals with the passive transport of water. Okay, and here this part will actively pick up the sodium by using the pump. Okay, so this part mainly deals with the passive absorption or active absorption of sodium. Okay, that's how the urine is formed and the concentration of urine is maintained. The opposite flow of vasa recta and your loop of Henle is known as counter current mechanism. Okay, so this is your counter current mechanism, and a blood vessel that helps is known as vasa recta. Okay, there are so many questions. Yeah, one second, I'll just use color. So this is so I'll use it I'll draw it once again. So guys, I am drawing this as a part of nephron. So nephron looks like this. Okay, I'm not drawing it really properly. So nephron looks like this. This is the loop of Henle, and here a dotted line, I have drawn the blood vessel, which is vasa recta. So there is a counter direction flow of blood and fluid into the nephron, which helps in the exchange, right? Yeah. So we can go to the question. We can go to the question. We can go to the leaderboard. Okay. So, Aryan, you have to come back to your first position now. Okay, I cannot see the question here. So question is not coming. What happened? That's okay, guys. Just let's leave it blank and we'll wait for the time to pass and we'll go to the next question. That's okay. Yeah. Now, guys, this is again an interesting question. Let's see. Let's see. It can be easy if you know it, if you have studied it in detail, and if you, it will be difficult if you will answer it on a half knowledge.
Sonal, actually the question was not shown there, so I am directly showing you the PPT.
Yes, yes,
We discuss
yes,
the
you have.
question here so that we can move on.
Okay, sir. Yeah. So, okay. So there are how many sounds are encompassed in a heartbeat? It's like four, guys. So it's a lub and dub. And lubbed up sound, and there are two more sounds which you cannot hear. If you will just keep your ear at somebody's chest, you will be able to hear like a lubbed up, dhak dhak kind of thing. What do you say? Dhak dhak. It's not dhak dhak, it's lubbed up. Okay, but when you are going to do this with a stethoscope, you are going to hear four sounds. Okay, we don't have much time, so we won't elaborate this question. You can research it. Yeah, there are four sounds. Yes, sir, we can go to the next question. Somebody is muted, unmuted. Yeah, we can go to the next question, sir. Yeah, elaborate. I think you can do it in the class, right? The answer is four. Okay, quite a large number of time window is kept for today's test. I hope you got enough time to Google. So yeah, most of you have got it right. It's uremia, guys. Accumulation of urea in the blood is uremia. Hemodialysis is a technique. Okay, cystitis is the inflammation in the kidney, and urethritis is the urethra. When there is an infection, it is urethritis. I think it's not a difficult question. We can go to the leaderboard and the next question.
ಅದನ್ನೇ ತಗೋಬೋದು ಅಂತ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಮಮತಾ, ಆರ್ಯನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಡೌನ್. ಆರ್ಯನ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಗೋ ಅಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ರೀಚ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಅಗೇನ್.
ಅದು ಕನ್ಕೂಡ ಅಂತ ನಿಮಗೆ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ, ಬಟ್ ಫೋನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ರು ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ.
ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಡ್ ಯು ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿವಿಯಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್. Okay, yeah, so guys, first is the formation of urine. In this, first will be the ultrafiltration, like I told you. Then will be tubular reabsorption by the loop of Henle. And then the tubules have something to secrete and maintain a osmolarity of the urine. So the tubules will give their input by adding potassium and potassium mainly, and will make the urine osmolarity. So the last part is tubular secretion. So first is ultrafiltration, reabsorption, and tubular secretion. First everything will be filtered, then everything will be uptaken, and then osmolarity means proper concentration, kind of concentration of solutes in the urine. Yeah, glomerular filtration is ultrafiltration. Yeah. We can go to the next question. Aryan, what are you doing? Aryan, what are you doing? I told you to come down into the leaderboard. You genuinely came down. You didn't maintain your first position. Good, Srishti. Good, Mamita. It's an easy question again. We'll exceed this quiz like few more minutes because we gave a little more time. Okay, again was an easy question. Hemodialysis is the filtration of blood. When the blood is with a higher pressure and the blood cells also get filtered along with the filtrate. Okay, so it is going to be increasing the blood. It is going to be the increasing the amount of blood in the urine. So it's now called as hematuria. Uremia is the when there's a deflection in the concentration of urine. Okay, glycosuria, when there's glucose, when you are diabetic and you have glucose, so then it's known as glucosuria. Polyuria is known as going for urination so many times. Clear? Too much urination, yeah. Last question, 1 more minute. Srishti, everybody attack on Srishti. How come she's on the first position? Okay, good Srishti, good Mamita, very bad Aryan. Again, easy question, super easy question, and lot of time is given to answer the question. Let's see if there is a shuffle. Yeah, last question, right? Last question, guys. Don't worry. Ma'am, can you repeat how many sound does the heart produce? Yeah, so heart produce 4 sound, guys. So it's like one is okay, we'll talk about it. Two are audible in reality. Two can be heard with the stethoscope. Yeah, so I think we are done solving this question. We are not going to the answer. Sir, can we go to the answer graph? Yeah, 26 have got it correct. Lungs are the excretory organ, guys. They give out carbon dioxide. Yeah, they give out carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is a metabolic excretory waste. Why 23 people have answered some other option? Spleen is the graveyard of RBC. Okay, spleen is the structure which deals with the immunity. And it's the graveyard of RBC, okay, the RBC slaughterhouse. And lungs are the excretory structure, they give out carbon dioxide. Such an easy question, you made it wrong. Let's see the shuffle and the topper. Oh God, it's Mamita. Congratulations, Mamita. Good job. What, Aryan? Got lost, huh? Got demotivated easily. Congratulations, Mamida. We are now ending the Mentimeter. You can go back to your PUBG. So yeah, 4 sounds in the heartbeat. It's lap, dub, running water sound, and sound of hills. Okay. Who is the one? Aryan, be absent-minded like always, huh?